உயிரை அனுப்புகிறேன்.
Mr. Speaker, sir, I would like to thank the honorable members of this House. Indeed, I would like to thank the House for once again reposing confidence in me. This is a great honor which they have bestowed, and conscious of the responsibilities and obligations, it will be the solemn duty of myself and the democratic government to live up to the expectations and the aspirations of the people of Pakistan. Mr. Speaker, I would also like to thank you for the manner in which you have conducted the whole proceedings. This is the first time in our country's history that a no-confidence move has been made against a Prime Minister. It was a time which, for a variety of reasons, became fraught with tension. But the coolness, the calmness, the sobriety with which you held the proceedings have upheld the honor and the dignity of the House of Parliament. Mr. Speaker, we bear no ill will towards the members of the opposition. But I do consider it my duty to say that a no-confidence motion is not a joke. It shakes the entire nation. And not only does it shake an entire nation, the working of the machinery of that nation, but it also gives rise to fears about democratic institutions and indeed about its implications on the integrity and the unity of Pakistan. Therefore, I would appeal to the opposition not to oppose us for the sake of opposition. We all have a stake in this House. And since we all have a stake in this House, we must coolly and calmly ponder what the different ramifications of any move can be. Today, we have succeeded. But in any event, I feel that a continuous process as we have witnessed in the last week, or indeed in many months, is one which can be dangerous for democracy. And that is why I would appeal to them to strengthen democratic institutions, to give greater dignity to the name of Parliament. Because when we hear of horse trading, it is not any individual who is ultimately maligned. It is not even any party which is ultimately maligned. But it is democracy and Parliament itself which is undermined. And therefore, on this occasion, when the House has reposed confidence in the government and in myself, I would like to state before the Honorable Speaker that there is no ill will on our part, there is no malice on our part, but there is an appeal to all our friends, to the Honorable Members of the House who sit on that side, to think coolly and calmly about the future that we want. And I am sure that they will respond in a spirit which will serve the cause of Pakistan, the people, freedom, constitution, and democracy. I thank you, Mr. Speaker.